Welcome to a quick review of the Robots expansion for the monster party game MonsDRAWsity, an expansion that packed more punch than we expected.
MonsDRAWsity Robots comes from Eric Slosson, the same designer as the base game. It features artwork from a slew of different artists, all impressive. It was published in 2021 by Deepwater Games, who are now known as Friendly Skeleton Games.
This is technically the second expansion to MonsDRAWsity. The first one is called Cute Creatures, which we also have, but haven't tried yet.
Now, this expansion contains 50 new monster cards to add to your monster collection, all of which feature robots, basically robotic-looking creatures and things. It also provides you with a new player board, upping the overall player count of MonsDRAWsity by one. Now, along with this, there is one other big bonus in the box I had no clue we were getting when I picked up this game, a totally new way to play MonsDRAWsity.
You can see Mo's joy at this discovery in our MonsDRAWsity Robots unboxing video, which is up on YouTube right now.
There, in addition to my surprise, you'll get to see the small box this expansion comes in with its thin cardboard insert. Honestly, this seems like the kind of thing you're probably going to toss the box out. You're going to put it on a shelf somewhere and never recycle it, and it's going to sit there forever. But you're just going to add the cards to the base game box. The new player's board front matches the originals, but it does have the robots graphic on the back of it. Now, it is worth noting you don't get an extra dry erase marker to go with this. Now, as for the monster cards, the art is fantastic and features a wide variety of robots in different poses, with a bonus of not having anything that was overly scary or creepy.
Now, if you don't know how to play MonsDRAWsity already, go check out our review of the base game before continuing, as we're about to get into what the Robots expansion adds to the game.
So the big thing this box is meant to do is give you more monsters to describe and draw, and it does that through 50 new cards with robotic themes. The next thing it does, as already mentioned, is up the player count.
Then we get to the surprise.
Yeah, this is the new some assembly required variant rules that are included in Robots, which features a more cooperative, though still competitive, more cooperative way to play the game.
Now, when playing with this variant, the witness gets a full 30 seconds to look at and memorize their card. They then set a 30-second timer and start it when they are ready to start describing the monster they saw.
So the players, the artists, start drawing what the witness describes just like normal until the timer runs out. Now, that's only 30 seconds. Then they pass their board to the player on the left. A new 30-second timer is started, and the witness starts describing again. Players are now adding to the artwork that was passed to them from the last player.
Play continues like this in 30-second segments, with each player being passed a different board and adding on to the work done by the other players until they get their board back. Note, if you play with only two players, you should swap boards twice.
Next, all the drawings are revealed. The witness picks the one they think best matches the card they saw. Note they're not allowed to look at the card at this point. They then flip over the card so the entire group can see it, and the artists vote on which one they think best matches the actual card. Now, unlike the regular game, artists are allowed to vote for their own board in this particular case because they're not the only people that contributed to it.
The witness gets a point if the majority of artists vote for the same drawing that they did. Each artist gets a point if they vote for the same drawing the witness picked. A full game has each player being a witness twice, just like the base game.
So here's the thing with this. These new rules, the some assembly required rules, in my opinion, are better than the rules in the base game. Well, I appreciate having another player board, even though it's number 10 and I don't have a number 9, which I guess comes in the Cute Creatures expansion. And while it's great to have 50 new monsters, like I love it. I wanted new monsters. That's why I bought this. But the real prize to me in this is this new variant rule.
I like the base game. I've played it a few times and I've had fun every time. But this version was immediately more fun.
Using some assembly required, to me, does a great job of leveling the playing field. It makes the game semi-cooperative. It removes any imbalance between the players as far as drawing ability, both in your ability to capture small details or elements, but also drawing speed. It also removes bias from the voting system, which I know most people can claim is not bias, but anytime you're voting for people, there's a tendency to play favorites. Well, at this point, every piece of artwork has been worked on by all players, so that part is removed. This overall makes the game more approachable and better for playing with groups of various ages, game experience, and artistic ability.
As well, the intrigue of seeing and contributing to multiple drawings is more engaging, especially when those times when your board comes back to you and you don't even recognize it as your own board because others have departed so greatly from your initial vision.
Yeah, there's all that is always a fantastic part of the game of getting your board back and just seeing what happened to what you started. Now, that said, there is a small potential issue with this game. After playing it multiple times, I did find one small problem with you have a player at the table who thinks they're better than everyone else. Like they, someone who's just so certain they know what the witness is describing that they try to fix every drawing they're given instead of just adding to them. Because this can erase some of the other players' work, which can be insulting. And it can also make it so all the drawings look similar at the end, which makes voting really hard when you're like, well, they all have the exact same thing on them.
While in our plays, I noted some similarities, really the fact that you're passing it around and only have 30 seconds to work does limit how much damage one player can do.
Yeah, that's true. And this doesn't happen with every group. Like it just came up and I was like, ooh, okay. I don't like people fixing other people's work because they think they're right, especially when you get to the end and they weren't right. And now they all have the same wrong feature on every card. So what I do recommend, and this is something I've had to do when playing with certain players, is say there's a no erasing rule where basically what I'm saying, like, you can erase if you make a mistake, but just don't. When given a board, all you're allowed to do is add new additional details, not change what's already there. Now, the other thing, though, is you also just want to encourage the witness to describe the creature in parts. You only have 30 seconds anyway, and that makes it so that each artist is going to focus on a different part of the creature. So you're going to, like, you know, start off with the overall kind of shape and body and then maybe focus on the head in the next 30 seconds. Next 30 seconds, focus on the limbs, and then the next 30 seconds, focus on small details.
So the more you play the game, the more you're likely to work in this manner anyway, I find.
Yeah.
Describing specific aspects of the image completely and then moving on to that next aspect is a benefit as it gives the artists more time to focus rather than trying to remember what you said first when you're already on to the third detail.
So the new rules are good. As for the new monsters, I dig them. I like them. One of my complaints about the base game is that some of the monsters in the original Monstrosity set are a little overly scary or creepy. And there are a lot of potentially phobia-inducing insect and arachnid-like creatures. So far, I haven't seen anything that I would describe at all scary, creepy, gross, or any of that in robots. This is a much more whimsical expansion with silly looking creatures rather than scary or creepy ones.
Though, don't think they're easy. There is some detail to these drawings and perspective and obscuration of details that, as one would hope, makes it anything but obvious how to best describe things in the limited time allowed.
Yeah, and I totally agree. I would actually say the monsters in this set, and I don't know if it's like from learning experience, they better knew what to tell the artist to do, just seem more dynamic than the ones in the base game. Like there's a wider variety of poses and there's a lot more like in action shots, like the things are happening. The one disadvantage I did find with everything being robots is you start to see a lot of repetition in the drawings, especially bolts, rivets, and panels. It's not a bad thing, but just enough that you're like, okay, yep, more rivets. Yeah. Oh, it's another drawing I've got with rivets. Oh, I see the last player or one of the other players has added rivets. What it made me want to do is just mix it in with one of the other sets, the base game, so that now and then you're drawing rivets.
Yeah, no, I think with any of the sets, you're bound to get some repetition as people come up with shortcuts to describe things. But yes, the rivets are possibly more problematic than most details in the sets we've come across.
Overall, I love robots. It's fantastic. I love Monstrosity Robots. I picked this up to get 50 monster cards. My youngest daughter should enjoy drawing because she's into sci-fi and robots. And I thought she'd love these and they'd be a little less creepy and scary. But then I got bonuses like the ability to play with one more player, as long as I remember to grab an extra dry erase marker. What I need to do is put one in the base game box and it won't be a problem. But most importantly, I got a whole new way to play my game that I actually found more fun than the original.
All in all, sort of a must buy for fans of this game.
Yeah, I agree. If you enjoy Monstrosity at all, pick this expansion up. It's very reasonably priced. And if nothing else, you get 50 new cards to keep the game fresh. The other stuff's going to depend. Like if you have a group of eight, you're probably not going to use that extra board very often. But I think everyone's going to dig these new variant rules.
And of course, if the new rules don't work for you, you haven't lost anything and still gained 50 new cards.
Now, here's the interesting one. And this is the one that, like, I kind of hope people who played MonsDRAWsity listen to this. Because if you own it and didn't love it, or if, you know, you were out to a public play event and you tried it and you're like, nah, I don't need this game. I encourage you to give the game another shot with the expansion and the subassembly required rules. Or just try the base game with the subassembly required rules, I guess, too. Because if what you didn't like about the game was players who drew better seemed to have an advantage, or players who drew quicker did better than anyone else because they could get more details on the board, or you didn't like the potential foibles of a voting system, the variant rules here fix all of those problems, in my opinion.
Well, thank you for joining us for this review of MonsDRAWsity Robots, an expansion that not only offers more content for a game we already dig, but also offers a whole new way to play that we found better than the original rules.
So what's a game you enjoy that was made better by an optional set of rules? These could come from an expansion like tonight's review, or it could be a variant included in the core rules, or maybe something you found on Board Game Geek or a local gaming Discord. I would love to hear it about. Oh yeah, I would love to hear about it in the comments below.
Did you dig this review? How about picking us up a coffee through ko-fi.com/tabletopbellhop? You can help keep us caffeinated and motivated.